On air, online, and on your smart speaker.
Get that feeling. On the Limestone Coast, this is SAFM.
SAFM News Briefing.
Hi there, I'm Matt Smithson with a national news briefing. Victoria has recorded its worst day of the pandemic so far, with 1,488 new COVID cases and two deaths. The regional areas of Moorabool, Shire and Shepparton have both entered fresh seven-day lockdowns. While in New South Wales, 10 people have died and there have been 813 new locally acquired cases. It brings the total number of people who've died in this outbreak in New South Wales to 362. But Queensland has dodged lockdown for another day. Two new locally acquired cases have been confirmed. The children of the man announced yesterday who'd spent 4 days on the Goldie while infectious. They were in quarantine for most of their infectious period. A new antiviral pill could halve the chances of dying or ending up in hospital from COVID, but scientists have warned the drug won't end the pandemic. The new pill is being developed in the US and the makers now want emergency authorisation to begin rolling it out. And Australia's airports are preparing for the return of overseas travel, which the Prime Minister has assured will resume next month. James Goodwin from the Australian Airports Association says it'll be great to welcome back international flights, but warns flying won't be the same.
But you shouldn't be scared of it. It just means that you're going to have to do a few more things before you depart. There are going to be changes to make sure that many of those permits, the vaccination certificates and so on, have all been done before you arrive at the airport. So that's going to be the main change.
Open your ears to a new world of audio, radio, podcasts, music and news. Catch Carrie and Tommy and much more on Listener. Download the new app and listen for free.
The Wallabies face Argentina tonight on the Gold Coast, with six Pumas players out of action stranded in New South Wales after crossing the border to Byron Bay without an exemption to return. In the women's day-night cricket test, India will resume on day three on 5 for 276 on the Gold Coast. India's opener Smriti Mandhana finally falling for 127 yesterday. The Aussies then managing to work their way through the middle order before storms brought an early end to action.
Buying or selling rural or residential properties? Miller, Wan and John. This is SAFM weather.
Cloudy on the Limestone Coast, a slight chance of a shower around the place. Showers around tomorrow too after an overnight low of 9. We're heading for a top of 17 on Sunday. And for radio, podcast, music and news, download the free Listener app.